for the vacant GTFB Bantamweight Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, the fighters are ready. So if you're ready, then make some noise and let's get it on! Please welcome one more time, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Reborn Fighting. Professional MMA record of 3 wins and only 1 loss. Ladies and gentlemen, Mafalda Mastringio Carmona! And her opponent in the red corner, representing Lions Gym. Professional MMA record of 2 wins and no losses. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome No Mess Mullins, Melissa!
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, cage door set to close on this women's pro bantamweight title fight. Melissa No Mess Mullins Dixon, fighting out of the red corner, representing the Lions Gym, putting her 2-0 record on the line against Mafalda Carmona, the Portuguese fighter in the blue corner, the yellow two-piece, a 3-1 record. All 4 fights in 2021 for Carmona, so she stayed busy as a pro, and Melissa Dixon has been in more fights than you can shake a stick at. She only loses decisions. She only wins by finishes.
Okay, came out firing straight away there. Could I love that little exchange.
Melissa Mullins, every time we see her develop as an athlete, she looks fitter, stronger.
She throws so hard as well. She has such power in those hands. Hence the amount of knockouts she has on her record. Carmona's no slouch herself.
She truly fights to finish, this Melissa Dixon, in every fight that she has. Amateur, pro, she's not getting paid for decisions.
Absolutely, and Monstrinho come over from the Reborn Fight Team, Lisbon, Portugal, into enemy territory here, but I mean, she just showed in those early couple of exchanges that she's happy to stand there and trade, but...
She absolutely is, but right now, knee to the midsection. Melissa pressing Carmona up against the cage. Carmona with that body lock.
Yeah, Melissa said before this fight that naturally she is a grappler, but she just loves the striking so much. She's got such power in those hands that... why grapple and wrestle when I could just knock you out?
Absolutely, and of course we're fighting pro as well, so the elbows can open themselves up, and that's just strength from No Mess as she deposits Carmona onto the back.
Yeah, Carmona there looked like she for a minute there she could have reversed the position, but just strength from Melissa Dixon
getting driven up into the cage. This Mafalda Carmona,
beautiful job there, pushing down on the right leg and sliding almost over into the half guard.
Almost locking down that half guard, Alarandi Couture, but instead just happy to muscle her opponent, trying to open up the head so she could chip away.
Yeah, she's doing a nice job there of controlling the left arm of Carmona there, so Carmona can't defend herself with that hand.
That's, again, Melissa Mullins Dixon, so strong. Talking to her husband, partner, training partner, James Dixon, he was saying, yeah, it's not nice when we both have to cut weight, especially her. But again, Melissa's looking, physically looking the best I think I've ever seen her.
Yeah, definitely. This is a mature couple of minutes so far into this first round. She's had some exchanges in the striking positions, but sensed here that she's got an advantage on the ground, and she's just strong and a big driving elbow.
Just posts on the chin and then drops the elbow down. Nasty.
Yeah, corner there. We're really happy with that. Just posting and then sliding that elbow down again.
Just nasty elbows designed to cut, slice.
Yeah, there was a big slicing elbow. And as I say, she's got that left arm trapped of
if she can step Carmona over, which she does. Carmona, good work getting that arm back. But you could see that Dixon was trying to force the arm between those legs, taking away any protection. Now she leans and chips away.
It's a very similar position to her last fight, I believe, when she beat Danielle Mistelli. She got that top position. She just kept firing
and
away.
Why not? You know, it's the path of least resistance. And right now, heavy shot.
Nasty elbows.
Referee.
This could be stopped
soon. It could be. Still no quit in Mafalda Kimona. She's trying to survive, but
and this is
that's a lot of time left in this round. I would have thought over a minute anyway for Melissa to really start slugging away.
And this is a really difficult position as well. That side control is a really difficult to get some to generate real fight-ending power, but Melissa does it.
Yeah, and those elbows.
Huge
it's
elbows.
Almost like,
yeah, like it's hard to describe, but they're thudding. They're just thudding elbows over and over again.
And again, just
she certainly doesn't just play for position in these ground situations.
And again, just
big cut open as well above the right eye there of Kimona. Yeah.
Well, how again? None of these are concussive, but they're chipping away and they're point stealing shots. They're round winning shots.
I think the referee is taking a close look at this because
well.
She's just
not,
landing over and over again, yeah, and she's not getting out of this position.
But it's not. Yeah.
It's not really fight ending, though. Like you say, it's just chipping
now
in.
Now onto the back.
A more annoyance than fight ending.
But and into the mount. Now this could be 10 seconds to go.
Yeah, she needs
Can
to
Mullen
survive these 10 seconds
out.
Here. Nice job there, bucking off the top. But I think she's going to be able to see out
hey,
the
look,
round.
If Mafalda Kimona wanted a way out of this fight, she got it there. She is game and she doesn't want out.
Look at her face already, absolutely busted up from those elbows. But I mean, let's not forget that Kimona herself is a finishing machine.
Yeah.
All three of her wins have come by knockout in the first round. Doctor stoppage and corner stoppage. She beats up her opponents.
Yeah.
And so far in this first round, we've seen the complete opposite whereby Melissa Dixon has just had her way with Kimona, especially when it hit the mat there.
When it hit the mat, it just looked like Dixon not only got better position, she was a little bit stronger on top. She chipped and hammered away. Lots of unanswered strikes. Not sure it's a 10-8. Not sure how close it was to being stopped.
Nasty cut there above the right. I'm just looking at our screens here. Real, like you said, I'm slicing elbows.
You know
it was a real nasty position as well, just above
the eye. You know what Dixon's
going
to target, don't you?
Absolutely. And it'd be interesting to see the tactics employed here from Kimona in the second round, whether she looks for the takedown herself, because I wouldn't want to stand and strike with Melissa.
Couldn't be much worse if she had a sign attached to her saying, punch here. Here we come out, Melissa.
No touch of gloves there. I think Melissa was...
I think she was looking for
it. Yeah, she was looking for it, but Kimona's like, no, thank you. Just busted me open in that first round. I want to get my own back.
Heavy low kick to open from no mess, Melissa Dixon. And again, she not afraid to stand in the pocket.
Yeah, Monstrino's happy to stand and exchange with Melissa Dixon.
Well, again... You don't make the flight over to Wolverhampton for Portugal because you want to make up the numbers. As lovely as Wolverhampton is.
Stiff left hand landed there from Melissa.
Again, economy of movement coming out of Melissa Mullins.
Nice little inside low kick there from Kimona and then dips out of range. She's got to look for that area where she can have some success herself. And
well, in the pocket, that's where, you know, Melissa lives. She loves that dirty.
Oh, big left hand lands there for Kimona. Happy to exchange here. Real fun back and forth.
Whoa.
Big right hand landed there. And another left hook wobbles Melissa. And she's
and
on wobbly legs here. But she's firing back herself.
Yeah,
I'm not sure whether this is the best game plan.
She's got to fight smart there. She was rocked a little bit.
Yeah, Kimona landing some big shots.
And Mullins in on the body lock, level change. Look to try and take it down because that first round from top position.
Kimona landed some very heavy left hooks in that exchange. And I'm not sure a firefight is, especially when we saw in the first round that path of least resistance.
Absolutely.
Get it to the ground, get into a dominant position and brutalize it with those elbows. I'm not sure.
Tried to throw that in, elbow off the break of the clinch, very nice.
Not sure how hurt there Melissa was, but.
I certainly think she knew that she'd been hit.
Yeah, definitely, she staggered back a little bit, so.
And again, off the clinch, Mafalda Kimona letting go.
And here they go again.
She's got quick hands.
Yeah, definitely. Whoa! The big right hand lands there. Huge right hand, and she's peppering it now with those shoveling shots.
Yeah, and you can see straight away Carmona close the distance to get that clinch. And now Melissa Mullins gets the body lock and throws her to the canvas.
Yeah, she didn't like that shot at all.
Not at all. That was a round changer. If Mullins stays here for the rest of the round, that one shot changed the complexion. But look, working to get the butterflies. Mathilda Carmona, again, not here to make up the numbers. She wants to put the O in Melissa Dixon's record.
Absolutely. I really love the use of the elbows from Melissa Dixon from the top position here when they're on the ground. Certainly cause a lot more damage with them.
Absolutely. But this is, again, looking to step over onto that arm. Then just chip away. Those shots are all going to score. Can't see if she's got a butterfly yet. It looks like
that on that left leg's in that butterfly position.
Yeah, and looking to try and...
She's so heavy though, isn't she, Melissa, to try and buck off with that butterfly sweep.
But Carmona uses the butterfly to lock down that full guard. She's holding on tight. It's a very neutral position. Referee's going to be looking closely. We've seen stand-ups already this evening. Oh, Mullins looking to get a little bit of posture.
As soon as she separates, though, Melissa, she's just looking to land damage all the time. Beautiful example.
Yeah, and there you go. Nice elbow. And she's going to slip her head out again. But as she does it, Carmona's bringing that guard up higher and higher, looking for the arm. But Melissa wise to that.
Yeah, like you say, she tends to stay in this neutral closed guard position on the bottom, Carmona, but she does, when she sees the opportunity, she lifts those legs up and looks for the arm. There you go. She's going to look for it again, I think.
I think she might look to transition for that triangle, perhaps.
Another
big elbow. As long as no mess stays busy here. And she's going to have to, because Mafalda has constant movement off the bottom. Controlling the wrist. Oh, lovely, lovely big elbow. Another heavy shot from No Mess.
She puts absolutely everything into those shots on the ground as well. They're not peppering strikes, are they? They're big thudding elbows. And be interested to see how Melissa comes out in this third round, because we've clearly seen the path of least resistance is to take Carmona down and stay heavy on top and land those big elbows. But she likes to put on a show, and it nearly cost her in that second round when she got wobbled.
Absolutely. You talked about the fact that, you know, Carmona, 3-1, all her fight wins come by way of finish. It's the same with Melissa Dixon, and it's going to be interesting to see whether we get a finish in the third and final round or whether these two young ladies are going to go the distance.
I tell you what, though, for the first all-female main event in UK regional MMA for a long time, this has been an absolutely great fight.
Absolutely, and you know the curse for Melissa Dixon is she's only lost via decision.
Absolutely, I mean,
as an amateur, all her losses came by way of split or majority decision.
Yeah, she doesn't know how to lose any other way, does she?
And
like you said, she doesn't know how to win any other way than by finishing her opponent.
5 minutes left to separate these two young ladies, Mafalda Carmona in the yellow, representing Reborn Fight Team, and No Mess, Melissa Mullins Dixon, in the gray shorts, black top.
She's changing again as the round opens up here. And this is exactly where Melissa will want the fight to be, in this clinch, looking for the takedown again. There's the level change.
Gets underneath those hips, got those hands clasped.
Carmona's beautiful job, just turned around the corner there. Carmona had to push down on the head there and try and force Melissa Dixon head down. But
she's such a physically strong bantamweight, is Dixon.
That's the problem. She just uses that strength and power and then just turned the corner beautifully. Took Carmona's back off the fence and again, he's back in this top position on the canvas, which has had loads of success through the first two rounds.
Dixon trying to pass that knee shield there. Looks like she's almost in the half guard, but she wants to stay heavy, and Carmona does well again. Gets both butterflies in now. Going to look to elevate Dixon if she can.
This is so heavy on top there. You could see that she's certainly trying to get that sweep and elevate Melissa, but she just does such a good job of maintaining that strong base.
But all the work the Kimona does on the bottom makes it much more difficult for Dixon. Like, she's not taking damage. Melissa's not been able to improve position so much.
Got to watch the arm bar.
Got to watch the arm.
Got to be careful.
Yeah, going to pull that arm out. Triangle.
Not a triangle attempt yet. So well, we're on the ball today,
and
aren't we,
then,
Steve?
Well, same with the Lions gym corner. Who are all giving her the same warning. But here it is, the control. That heavy top pressure.
This is a position where we've seen the most damage and the most control from Essex. And when she gets into this half guard or slips it over into the side control, she's been able to land some real vicious strikes on this position.
Yeah, opened up that right eye again. Just over the right eye. Staying heavy, pressuring is no mess.
Carmona's corner here. Barking out instructions in Portuguese, I assume she's saying, get back to your feet, because you cannot spend the rest of the round on the bottom, because you are going to lose this fight.
Certainly not in this fight. I mean, she's been active off the bottom. She's brought up the guard high. She's looked for things, but Dixon's just been one step ahead on the ground, and that just physical strength.
It appears that Carmona, when she's in that full guard position on the bottom, she's got looks dangerous, sweeps, brings the legs up for the submissions. But it's when she gets into kind of the half guard or the side control, she tends to just stall in that position. She's had the lockdown there on the half guard for about 45 seconds to a minute there, but not really doing anything with it. She's just trying to stop Melissa from getting into a more dominant position. She's not trying to regain that full guard position. She's purely defensive, and that's the problem. I think she might look back on this fight and look at these moments where she realises that, I can be dangerous when I'm in the full guard, but it's when I get into the other positions on the ground that maybe I'm not quite active enough, or I'm not active enough in getting back to that full guard and then being able to look for the sweeps and submissions.
Looking to see if she can perhaps use that cage to push off, but again, Dixon wise to it. She's got a real heavy base now, chest to chest, side control.
Yeah, she's...
She's gonna,
happy to see it out in this position. I mean, obviously she liked the finish with all finishes on the record so far, but I mean, given the fact that all of her losses have come by decision, she probably pretty happy to win a decision.
To break that duck egg. That's certainly what I'll ask her, you know. You went the 15.
Yeah.
Decision went your way.
Yeah, and that's really important as well. As your third fight as a professional, to go the 15 minutes as well, get those minutes under your belt, that's really important as well.
It just shows you that you can on the back now. Not a lot of time left to work. She's still going to smother.
Yeah, Carmona doing a good job there, turning to a left, turning into Melissa, not to give up her back, but...
3-1, Mafalda Carmona. Welcome to the UK. You can come back anytime, young lady. Mullen's just going to try and get that left leg out. No, good work again.
Yeah, lovely work there. She nearly gave up the full mount, but did a good job getting back into the half guard. 10 seconds left, and it's the story of the fight, isn't
it? Absolutely.
Melissa Dixon on top.
Look at chipping away when she can.
And absolutely fun back and forth, especially in that second round with the striking changes, but... For the vast majority of it, it was Melissa Dixon in that top control, landing heavy ground and pound and controlling Mafalda Carmona.
I've been a Melissa Dixon, Melissa Mullins fan since her amateur debut. I'm now a Mafalda Carmona fan. She came here, fought her ass off. Not happy. Well, when I get into the cage, we'll have a chat about that. Not happy with a 15-minute... I'm going to presume she takes the decision here.
I think she quite comfortably takes that decision, but that just goes to show that the mindset of Melissa Dixon.
Absolutely.
She's not happy that she's spent a vast majority of the time on top landing brutal elbows to her opponent. She loves those finishes.
She does want the finish, without question. And Mafalda Carmona just refused to give her refused to give it the opportunity.
Yeah, and I'd love to see Mafalda Carmona come back to the UK Live Show.
Oh, yes,
compete
please.
On GTFP in September. She's certainly, you could tell on the feet why she's got three knockout victories or three finishes on her record, because she stood there and traded with Melissa Dixon. It was only when the fight hit the mat, really, that she kind of didn't have her own way in this fight. And Melissa kind of took the upper hand. But, I mean, the stand-up exchanges, she rocked
phenomenal.
Melissa in the second round.
Well, for the last time this evening, we give a quick shout-out to some of our sponsors, to Nantan, to Live MMA, Corrupt Sheriff, Elephant Mobile, Combat Sports Clinic, Sapology, Keto Pro, and Wentworth James Construction Recruitment. Thank you very much for joining us. Golden Ticket Fight Promotions 19. I've been Steve Cook-Abbott for John Prentice, and we will leave you with this official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together one more time for both of these fighters. After three rounds, the judges have reached a unanimous decision. To the winner and the new Golden Ticket Fight Promotion Bantamweight Champion, Melissa Bantamweight champion, no less, Melissa Dixon. You said to me at the end of the fight you weren't happy with the performance, but that's the first decision you've actually taken, amateur or pro. You've finally gone the full distance and taken the win. Talk to us about the fight and your opponent.
I don't really know what to say. I'm unhappy with my striking, but I'm obviously happy with the win. I want to display a better display of striking because I feel that's my strongest suit in the cage. Today clearly was my ground game, and I relied on that quite heavily. I found the striking was good and I thought I could counter it a lot more, but for some reason I switched off on the upstairs game. And with that I'm disappointed, but I'm not disappointed with my performance overall.
Well, no way you should be disappointed with that performance. This young lady came from Portugal not to make up the numbers. She came to test you, and it was a test you passed with flying colors. What's next?
This is my, I think, last one at bantamweight, at least for a while. It was a hard cut. But we made the weight professionally, like we said we were going to do and what we agreed to do. Hopefully I'll be fighting on the next card at Golden Ticket at 65 kilos. Stephanie Paige Evans is been a name that's been mentioned, so I hope to fight her. Anyone else at 65 kilo who wants to take me on, let's go.
You've got a ton of support. Anything you want to say to your fans in the audience?
Hello. Firstly, I want to say thank you to all my friends and family that came over to support me today. Secondly, I'd like to say thank you to my gym, Lions Gym Coventry. If it wasn't for this gym, I would not be the performer I am today. And lastly, if it wasn't for my sponsors, Big Watch Bros, my partner James Dixon, Paul Clinic, The Personal Touch, Josh Merritt, who does my strength and conditioning, Lolo Lou's Cupcakes, and Carter Boxing. I wouldn't be able to put on the performance that I did today because they allowed me to take time away from my normal lifestyle schedule to be able to make these kind of debuts, performances.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for your still undefeated and now Golden Ticket Fight Promotions Women's Bantamweight Champion, no mess, Melissa Dixon.
And don't realize you're the moment until it's not happening.